My name is Dr. Ishita Sen, and I'm a nuclear medicine physician at the Fortis Memorial Research Institute, Gurugram, India. And my area of specialization is radionuclide therapy. One of the key areas of using radionuclide therapy is in neuroendocrine tumors, where we use a therapy called PRRT, which is peptide-linked radioisotope therapy, for the treatment of well-differentiated neuroendocrine tumors. Now, this is a very, very targeted therapy, which basically helps in treating patients who got a well-differentiated neuroendocrine tumor. So those which are low-grade neuroendocrine tumors or intermediate-grade neuroendocrine tumors, these are typically the kind of tumors which are amenable for PRRT. These tumors do not respond to standard chemotherapy, and PRRT is the standard of care for these tumors. PRRT uses two different kinds of radioisotope. So the usual standard radioisotope which is used is called Lu-177, which is Luetitium-177, which is linked to a peptide which basically targets the somatostatin receptors on the tumors of neuroendocrine tumors. So these somatostatin receptors act like beacons to which these radio particles go and get attached. They give local radiotherapy at the site of the tumor, and they kill the cells, they kill the cancer cells. The beauty of this procedure is that the normal cells around the tumor cells are not affected. So it's a very, very highly targeted kind of therapy. It is very well tolerated. It is given as either an intravenous drip or sometimes in patients who've got a lot of disease only in the liver, it may be given as an intra-arterial administration. So you put in a cannula through the hepatic fusion, which takes about 10 to 15 minutes to administer. And along with the PRRT drug, we give some infusions of amino acids to protect the kidneys. The PRRT is very, very well tolerated. Most patients are able to do this as an outpatient or a daycare admission. Post-PRRT, there may be a little bit of fatigue and nausea for 1 or 2 days, and most patients are able to return to their normal. PRRT is given as fractions, so it is given as doses. So you have one cycle which is given every 3 months, and usually 4 to 6 cycles are given. And only in those patients who have a positive gallium totanox scan can we offer PRRT. Now, the PRRT, just like you can label it with lutetium, you can also, there is an advanced form of PRRT which is called alpha PRRT. So alpha PRRT is the same PRRT molecule, but this time it is labeled to a substance which is called actinium. So actinium, or in some cases lead-213. So usually patients who do not respond to lutetium become eligible for alpha PRRT. In very few kind of patients, you may use alpha PRRT as a first line therapy. And alpha PRRT is also given, just like lutetium PRRT, as cycles at intervals of between 2 to 3 months, and typically about 4 to 6 cycles of alpha PRRT are also administered. So PRRT is now a US FDA approved. In 2018, after the Netter 1 trial, which was the biggest, so almost for the past 20 years, the PRRT has been the kind of standard of care for patients of neuroendocrine tumor.